What's up, everyone? Welcome to Lauderdale-By-The-Sea. I'm going to be walking around this little tiny town in Broward County today. It's located just north of Fort Lauderdale. And there's a lot to do here. There's live music being played at the beach. The pier is right behind me, the historic Anglin's Pier. Unfortunately, it was damaged and it hasn't been repaired yet. But let's get this walk started. I'm recording this walk on Thursday, January 26, 2023. It's 4:30 p.m. and it's 76 Fahrenheit, 24 Celsius. We're right now at the Aruba Beach Cafe, which is right on the beachfront here. Had a great turkey sandwich here. I saw a live band in here. Let's see if they're still around. Yes, they are. This cafe is so cool. Hi, thank you. Have fun. This place is great. So this is Commercial Boulevard, Lauderdale by the Sea's main street.
And this old guy walked by this.
Despite its name, Lauderdale-by-the-Sea is not part of the city of Fort Lauderdale. It's its own town. I saw that live band here somewhere. There's actually a fee to go onto this pier, but since it was partially destroyed, I don't think we'll have to pay. Here's the historic pier. It's on the renovations. Hopefully they'll be able to get it fixed soon. Let's see how much damage this pier actually took. Looks like there's a big gap. That looks like it's going to take a while to fix. Not the greatest day to come by the beach with the cloudy skies. I love this little central plaza with the lounge chairs. Take a look at the menu here at Mulligan's Beach House. Got a good variety. Seems similar to the Aruba Cafe where I ate at. I think this town may have done something for the holidays with these lights around the trees. They didn't get around to take them down yet. Souvenir shop, Lauderdale-By-The-Sea, Florida. This seems like an Italian restaurant, Vinny's. Step in and I'll show you the interior. Hi! Wow, what a store. It smells like sugar in here. I haven't been in a dessert spot this extensive in a while. Chocolates, cookies, ice cream. Let's check out the rest of this town. There's some more happening down here. This is State Route A1A, the main beach roadway. BurgerFi Natural Burgers across the street. I think I'll walk on the other side of Commercial Boulevard once I'm done with this side, and then maybe head over to the residential area. Fort Lauderdale Beach is about 5 or 6 miles to the south of me. To the north of me is Pompano Beach, a place that I've visited before. Cute little pub. I saw a pool table in the back. There's a Vietnamese grill. Got some outdoor seating. Doesn't look too busy. I hope they're able to get customers for the evening. Billy Jack Shack. This looks like a really cool place. It's amazing how busy this street gets as we walk away from the beach. I think there's a strip mall over to my left. Or maybe this is a car dealership. Uptown Pieces, Beach Hardware and Paint Center. There's some really cool looking art pieces in Lauderdale-By-The-Sea. Chicago Stuff Pizza Company and a bike shop. I would think the bike shop here would do pretty good considering it's right by the beach. I'm seeing a lot of people on their bikes cycling up and down. I'm not really too sure how I'm going to cross the street here though. I like to explore the other side of the street, but there's no traffic signal. Might have to do it over here, coming up where the crosswalk is. Even then, I don't really feel too comfortable crossing there. You know what I'll do? I'll maybe walk down here. Go into the residential street for a block or two and then cross at that crosswalk that I passed earlier. It's a hair salon and a spa. Compared to Commercial Boulevard, it's so quiet here. And this isn't really the residential area, it's down that way where the residential area is. Now I'll be able to cross the street easier. Let's go this way and then we'll cross again. public parking all day, $10. I should have parked here. Blazing Scissors. Looks like a rather small hair salon. That way. That's actually closer to where I parked my car. Italian bakery. Actually looks quite nice in there. Taco Craft seems like a restaurant I've seen before. I think it might be a chain. I know this place is a chain, Kilwin's Chocolates. I've eaten at Kilwin's in Clearwater Beach. They're known for the desserts. Boston Beef by the Sea. Lobster roll for $24. Local pizzeria. This way on Elmar Drive. I'll walk you through some of the residential area. is a timeshare property. Does seem to be a nice little spot if you want a timeshare. And you have the beach patio across the street. Looks like this is new construction. Did it Villas by the sea. Same complex across the street. Here's the parking lot that I parked at. It's $3 an hour to park here, and I put $4 in. I mean, $12 for 4 hours. Let's cross the street here to El Prado Park. Then I think I'll wrap up my video of Lauderdale by the Sea. No dogs. All right, everyone. Hope you enjoy this video of Lauderdale by the Sea here in Broward County. If you enjoyed it, hit the like button, subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye, everyone. Take care.